Okay, so it's like almost 8 o'clock, 7:58. My car is on its way here. It is Tuesday, November 20th, day before Thanksgiving. I have worked all day, y'all, like all day. I'm getting ready to go home. Well, I'm getting ready to fly to see my parents and spend Thanksgiving with my parents and my siblings. So I got a late flight. For some reason, we always meet on these late flights, okay? But hopefully I don't see like nobody cute in the airport because I look rugged. My eyebrows is, my hair is dusty, everything uneven. Like I just look trash right now. But it's okay because I'm on my way to my favorite place, which is my house with my parents. Let's get
Hello everybody, welcome to my corner. Woo!
Welcome to my corner. Let's have a talk now. From Miami to California, yeah. Check your girl out. I'm gonna give it to you straight up. That's right, that's right. Keeping it real, no things inside.
Let's go.
Welcome to my corner, y'all.
Tell you what I'm thinking right now. Like, why do I keep flying at night? Why do I keep doing this to myself? I'm so tired. I just want to sleep. Like, why, Lord? Why do I do this? Why?
Welcome back. Welcome back. Welcome back.
Welcome back.
Just landed. Y'all, I wish I could have vlogged everything that happened, but baby, it was a lot going on in there. I'll tell y'all the story later. So I'm here waiting on my siblings. I'm ready to go to bed. This late night travel ain't for me. Look at my eyebrows. Look at my face. Boiling, ready to go to bed. Everybody, welcome back to the vloggy. So getting ready to head out with my mom. It's day two. It's Wednesday.
Candace. Oh, mother. I need to sign this book and put it in the mail.
Yes, mother.
This girl paid me for it. Donald Industries. You remember her?
I'm vlogging. You don't even care. That's my mom. I'll show y'all her. Say hi.
Hi.
So we're about to get ready to go get stuff for Thanksgiving. What are we going to get? Why are you nervous?
Quite a few things. I don't know.
So, yeah. So, it's me and my mom today. So, come along with us and enjoy the ride. Ready?
Yep.
All right. All right. So, store number one. It's very ethnic of you. She got this scarf on her head. It's an ethnic scarf.
I don't normally do this. I normally have my hair, like, flayed.
So do I.
We're going to be very ethnic today.
We're the same because I call it.
Hi there, guys. It's good to see my baby girl.
This
is my buttercup right here.
True that.
My ride or live girl.
Yeah,
other than
I'm definitely
Keturah.
Not dying. I'm definitely not dying.
I miss her.
I miss you too, girlfriend.
Girl, we have to do some songs for you guys.
All right, so we're in store number one. Let's see how long it takes us to find what it is we got. What are we going in here for?
Don't worry about it.
Okay. Going to the grocery store, to breakfast, to the house. Now we're at clothing stores. I'm not complaining because I would like to buy new clothes, but my mom is literally me. Like, I promise you we're not gonna finish till at least like 3 o'clock today. And then she's gonna be like, oh, I forgot something. Like, girl.
Come back. Welcome back. Welcome
back. Welcome back. My mama trying to get me in these teeny bop gowns with pink and turquoise and bedazzled sparkles.
I'm too grown.
Huh? We were supposed to get food, y'all. We were in a store buying clothes. This is the sixth store. I had a shopping problem, but I get it from my mama. Like, Lord Jesus. She's like, Candace, help me find this. Candace, help me find that. Girl, I'm ready to go.
7 hours later.
So it's about 3 o'clock. Finally finished. I look a mess, you guys. Don't mind me. I'm a little cuter, like Thanksgiving Day. We literally just got home 3 o'clock. So now we're about to start the kitchen prep, which is about to take us all day, you know. I don't know about y'all, but in our household, I cook, you know what I'm saying? I clean, I help my mom out. So I'm about to cook greens, season chicken, get the meat ready for tomorrow. And all things give thanks, you know what I'm saying? The good thing is, I ain't have to pay for none of this food, so I'ma eat and be happy. So let's get into the kitchen, because I think y'all gonna be shocked. Y'all gonna see what Chef C can do. Okay, let's get to it. Welcome back. Okay, so I was supposed to vlog everything of like me, but y'all, I got so sleepy, I got so tired.
So now it's like 7 o'clock. I did help my mom cut the greens though, but everything else I was supposed to do, I didn't do. So 7 o'clock, it's kind of late. I was supposed to cook dinner today, that didn't happen. So we about to eat out, I'm guessing. It's still the same day, the day before Thanksgiving. So I don't know about y'all, but in our household on holidays, you know, in addition to ham and turkey and everything else, we have something called fried chicken. And I'm not gonna say that I'm the best fried chicken maker ever, but I'm just gonna say, like, I've never had nobody tell me my fried chicken wasn't everything. So we're just gonna call this segment Cooking with Candace, Chef C. So I'm gonna show y'all what I do. I'm actually not cooking the chicken till tomorrow, but the key to having amazing food is all about the seasoning and the preparation. So my mom's already cooked the macaroni and cheese. She's already cooked the stuffing. She's already done the greens. Normally I do the turkey too, like turkey wings, but like this year she had a smoked turkey, so we good. So all I'm about to do now is do the chicken, and I'm gonna show y'all how it's done. So let me show y'all how I cook. First things first, before you wash your chicken, make sure you wash your hands, which I did. So I season chicken with a lot of different things. I live in Louisiana, so we live by this, and we live by this, okay? So, like, I got my parents on this because, hello, I live in Louisiana. Garlic powder, that's, like, in every household. Believe it or not, I use Goya, which is, like, a lot of Latinos use this seasoning. We use it in my chicken. Garlic pepper. And I need some garlic salt, but it's okay. It'll make up for it. And I'm actually gonna use mustard. I'll show it to you later. Okay, so first things first is you wanna make sure that your food is seasoned, okay? Now, if you have like high blood pressure and stuff, gotta season strong. If you have high blood pressure, you gotta be careful of the seasonings and stuff. You don't wanna get diabetes. Hold on, y'all. Season's trying to take me out. Something in there is making me sneeze. And then it's an art to it. You want to put all your seasonings in here. Every single season. I don't know if y'all can hear my mama. She on the phone. Get the flick of your wrist. Hey. All right, I'm sorry. So after you season it the first time, you're using your hands that are clean, you're gonna stir it into the chicken. Stir the chicken. So like turn over the chicken that you just seasoned, because it's a lot. So you wanna make sure that every part of the chicken is seasoned. So you mix it up, turn the chickens over, right? And now it looks like it's not seasoned again. So then I go back for round two, using the other hand. And I just season the chicken again. And pour a little coat over it again. Same seasonings, nothing different. I think this is what's making me sneeze. The Goya. All about the wrist. All about the wrist. Hey, hey. All right. So you mix it up one more time. You want to make sure, depending on what type of chicken you're cooking, that, you know, you cut off, like, any fat. So, like, these are chicken wings and legs, so not much fat. But, like, if I was cooking thighs and stuff, definitely, definitely want to make sure it's good. Okay, so before I season one more time, I'm going to take this. You can use any type of mustard you want, but mustard actually gets your chicken to stick to the flour. So, like, if you put it on shrimp, if you put it on fish, put it on chicken, it'll cause the chicken to stick to the flour. A lot of people don't know that. I just kind of found this out a few months ago, actually. And so I started cooking my chicken like that. Restaurant to eat ever. Everything is so good. I'm about to show y'all. Like, every time I come to Tampa, I eat here in Publix. Baby, Jesus is in this. So I slacked on my vlogging yesterday because I really didn't do much. And like after Thanksgiving, I had family time and I forgot to vlog it. Like y'all know sometimes I forget to vlog things. So today is my last day in Florida. I'm not really doing much. Like we're going to put the tree together and stuff because it's officially Christmas. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Y'all know I love Christmas. If you didn't know, now you know. I live for Christmas. Actually, I've been celebrating Christmas since Halloween was over, but still. So we're gonna get ready to put the house together, like with some decorations and stuff. And then I fly out super early tomorrow. So I'm just gonna spend some family time and, you know, chill. You know what I'm saying? Let's get to it.
Final product. It's super cute. I'm proud of my parents because normally their house is the worst house on the block. And compared to everybody else, I think they did pretty well this year. Now, they usually do a whole entire light competition like the 1st of December. So my parents definitely aren't going to win. But we applaud them for this. This is cute.